Chrissie Rhodes and Ben Earle are better known as British country band The Shires. In just 5 years, they've had 3 top 10 albums and recently wowed the crowds in Hyde Park. They've recorded a special version of their favourite hymn exclusively for Songs of Praise. Claire McCullum went to find out more.
Well, Chrissie and Ben, so good to see you. Hard to believe 5 years have passed since you got together, but take me back to when you first started.
Music's always been a massive part of my life from very early on. When I was about 6 or 7, I was playing the recorder, as we all do at the start.
Compulsory.
I was a chorister actually at St George's, Windsor, so from the age of 7. My mum basically couldn't afford to get me into the school, and my mum never takes no for an answer, and so she got me a voice trial. I don't know how she did it. And then, yeah, I ended up singing in the castle, in the chapel, and it was kind of like Harry Potter. I was in this little boarding school, and I felt very lucky to go there. And
but you didn't even realise at the time, like, the importance of that.
No,
you
know,
because you were so young, you just...
And we're singing at royal weddings, and you're singing for the Queen at Easter matins and stuff. But I think in terms of, like, the training, you know, getting up every day, we used to sing every day. We had to do school as well, and we had this thing called 100 steps, which is sort of go up the side of the castle. They don't do it anymore because health and safety, it was really dangerous, actually. But we used to go up these 100 steps, and get... It was actually 106, but they called it 100 steps. Got to the top, and we used to sing every day.
What is it about country music?
Country music is all about the honesty and the storytelling, and you know, when Ben and I first met, we both loved the genre, and I think a lot of people thought it was just about the kind of rhinestones and the cowboys, and it very much is about that out in the States, but over here, you know, it's about the storytelling and it's about, you know, everyday life. It's kind of for the working people, and it's to kind of take people out of a moment that they're going through, or help them through kind of difficult times. That's what country music is all about.
And take me back to your gospel choir days as well. I mean, I know you grew up in church and so on, and then it progressed into gospel choir singing.
It was just so emotional, and just every time we were singing, you know, the lyrics, we always just fully believed all the, you know, the words that we would sing. And there's something just so magical about being together and everybody singing together, you know.
We have recorded a special hymn for us. Tell us what it is and why it's special.
It's Jerusalem, and it's a song that both of us grew up singing, you know.
It's so emotional, that Jerusalem, it just sort of, hear it sung and you feel proud, but you also feel a bit reflective as well.
It was taught to us in schools and churches, you know, so we've always been singing that song. I just find it's really uplifting and gives, you know, a good spirit for everybody.
We wanted to be true to the hymn, but also, you know, keep ourselves as well, and I think we did it.
And did those feet in ancient time walk upon England's mountains green, and was the Holy Lamb of God on England's pleasant pastures seen, and did the countenance divine shine forth upon
and blue.
If you'd like to join us to sing some of these favourite hymns, then why not come along to our annual Big Sing? This year we're recording in the newly restored McEwen Hall in Edinburgh on Sunday the 18th of November with a fantastic lineup of performers. To buy tickets, go to our website bbc.co.uk/songsofpraise or call 0871 220 0260. Calls cost 13 pence per minute plus your network's access charge. The words and imagery of the Bible so often provide inspiration for hymn writers. Here's Josie Darby with a favourite hymn taken directly from the scriptures.
When it comes to choosing a favourite hymn, there is something extra special about singing an actual psalm from the Bible. And for me, the Lord's My Shepherd, Psalm 23, really is a very personally meaningful song. So I'm going to choose that and hear it set to the beautiful tune of Crimond.
Next week, 100 years since he was killed in action during World War I, we celebrate the life and works of war poet Wilfred Owen with hymns and, of course, poems from his home church in Birkenhead.
Well, I've had a wonderful time here with the Chelsea Pensioners, and before we go, I'd like to share with you my favourite hymn. It's the first hymn that I felt an emotional connection to as a chorister, and it's called Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. See you next time.